What are the factors that keep one company safe while another company gets ransomware? Some of the best solutions are actually surprisingly affordable. We dive into the most under-leveraged security technology. Hi, this is Carsten from Hacking Matters, where every week we look at the best practices in hacking defense. Today we're exploring ransomware resilience. What are the factors that keep one company safe while another company gets ransomware? There's many factors coming together in ransomware resilience, too many to count, perhaps. Today, we're going to look at specifically the ones that I think make the biggest difference and that some companies use them and others not yet. And specifically, we dive into what I believe is the most under-leveraged security technology. To set the stage, and to recap what we discussed in a previous video on hacking journeys, hackers break into organizations in three steps. They compromise an initial host or person, they then move laterally to finally then cash out, in this case, perhaps encrypt or steal files. Defenders, as again we established in another video, go through three activities themselves. They prevent, detect, or respond to hacking incidents. Every hacking defense lives in this matrix, doing something in three areas to prevent something in three other areas. And most effort is spent on preventing the first defense stage, intrusions, and lateral movement. So as defenders, we're very focused on stopping hacking journeys early. By us being so focused on prevention, we're basically letting hackers also focus on prevention, knowing that once they break in initially, they can move laterally and cash out almost undisturbed. So today, I want to bring the attention a little bit more onto the detection and response capabilities. So in that 3x3 matrix, I believe that detecting the lateral movement and responding to the cash out are the more important levers that people are not yet using after implementing really good controls around prevention in many organizations already. Let's briefly tackle the latter one first, responding to the cash out stage, because we already have two other videos on this, on best practices in backup and recovery, as well as the reasoning why you want a cyber insurance. And short summary on backup and recovery, you need to be ransomware resilient in that you move everything into a red forest, a tier zero model. Go check out that video if that's not a familiar concept. Very important so that you can recover from a ransomware hack. And around cyber insurance, what's most important is that you do have a partner by your side. Not so much that they pay for the losses, in most cases they don't, but that they help you understand what happened, negotiate with the criminal, and basically inform your stakeholders in a way to limit the damage to your business. Again, there's a separate video, so we're not gonna go too deep into that. That leaves what I believe is the most under-leveraged security control out there: detecting lateral movement through honeypots and honey tokens. Honeypots and honey tokens are basically simulated technology assets on fake documents that you sprinkle across your network or your cloud assets so that a hacker looking for technology to hack or documents to steal encounters them, where your normal staff in a normal way of doing business, they never access those systems and they never access those documents. If anyone touches these honey assets, you know that they're looking for more access or more information. So a hack is unfolding, and that alert can now enable you to take action and evade the hacker from your network before it's too late. Honey assets are deployed best in the lateral movement stage of the hacking journey, because if you deploy them later than that, you already know that you got hacked. If everything is encrypted, too late to take action. If you deploy them early in the initial intrusion, you're basically just measuring the noise of the internet. You want to focus your honey assets onto your internal networks, onto your internal cloud assets, so that only somebody who has already broken into some part of your organization can possibly access them and thereby trigger those alerts. So it's a very high quality alert. You know that a hacking journey is currently unfolding. There are many commercial deception tools available, some of them more expensive, some of them cheaper. Price does not correlate with value here though. Some of the best solutions are actually surprisingly affordable. Today, I'm going to point you to two solutions that are completely for free even, both of them in the context of a Windows environment, because Windows is still the most common hacking frontier, especially when it comes to ransomware. The first Honey token that you can deploy with almost no effort is a Windows account, a high-privileged Windows account that a hacker thinks they can log into, but ultimately fail to log in, creating an alert. What is that Windows account? You want it to be as juicy as possible, so preferably a domain admin account, and you want that domain admin account to be sprinkled across as many systems as possible that a hacker might encounter. You create a domain admin account with a somewhat weak password. You make it log in to many computers so that that weak hashed password is cached on the systems, and you set the lock-on hours of that account to never. So how does that look towards the hacker? The hacker breaks into one of these Windows computers. They think they got very lucky because there is a cached admin credential, and they got even luckier that they can brute force that weak password. And then they try to use the password, giving you an alert that somebody tried to use that account, the account that you never want to use, but that's only there as a tripwire. Very easy and very hard to avoid for the hacker technique. The second Honey asset that you can also deploy for free evolves around the Active Directory Certificate Service, or for short, ADCS. This is a service that is often abused by ransomware gangs, because if it is vulnerable to a certain issue, then you can create a certificate that basically gives you access to everything forever. So the holy grail for a ransomware criminal. Whether or not it is vulnerable, hackers just try it out. And if they get lucky, they generate that certificate. So my team at SR Labs actually created a honeypot that uses ADCS to pretend that it's vulnerable, but then immediately on issuing this golden ticket, the entry ticket for everything forever, as soon as that's issued, it revokes the certificate. So the hacker never gets a chance to use it. But by trying to generate one, they created a very high fidelity alert that almost guarantees you that a hacking journey is currently unfolding on your internal network. The ADCS honeypot is open source from us. It's relatively easy to deploy, and it hopefully is deployed by many of you and many organizations around the world. Even if you don't deploy it though, even the rumor that it could have been deployed already has most of the effect, because what we want ransomware gangs to do is not try this technique anymore, being scared that they might fall into a trap. So even just knowing that a honeypot is out there already complicates hacking journeys. And therefore, it's even more important that many of you start using deception technology, honey tokens, honeypots, and talk about them as much as possible so that the ransomware criminals become more and more and more careful in how they exploit organizations, and thereby slower and slower and slower until at some point, for some of them, this is not a valid business model anymore. So there you have it. Deception technology for the win, deploying honey tokens, deploying honeypots to be better at detection, specifically in that lateral movement stage of a hacking journey that currently we don't have enough visibility in. It's not more or less important than other security tools like backup and recovery, like an EDR, like good patching and hardening. But for most of you, it will be an under-leveraged tool in that you're already using many of these other technologies, but you're not using deception yet. So a good investment area, and not a big investment either, given that many solutions are relatively inexpensive or even for free. Hopefully this allows all of us to step up our game in terms of ransomware resilience. The world definitely needs to become more resilient, looking at how many critical organizations, schools, hospitals, food production, critical infrastructure is actively being targeted and often victim to ransomware resilience. If you have additional ideas on how to become ransomware resilient, please share them in the comments below. And if this was useful to you or your organization, we'd appreciate if you show it through a like and subscribe. And until then, happy hacking.